So Dan, in a little time, 2-3 minutes, how was this panel discussion through your lens, through your view? What should the member that came or the member that didn't come find out in 3 minutes?
Me personally, I think it was a great talk because we had really outstanding people in their fields, top of what we have in Romania. So it was very, very useful to pick on their brains and to see their perspectives. Now, on the topic, the specific topic of today, how to build an economy-proof organization, might it be, I don't know, robust, resilient, or even, as I said, anti-fragile, that actually grows and benefits from adversity and from crisis or whatever shock it might be. I think more relevant are the discussions, and there were some, many actually, in the panel, about what the companies do, so at the micro level. If we focus on the economy, of course the economy will be hit and there will be shocks and ups and downs. But at the micro level we can do a lot of things, and this was my favorite part and the part where I actually can speak about from experience and from other people's experience. What can we do today and every day to be prepared for shocks, to gain from shocks? What can we do in preparing the companies, not trying to anticipate the downturn or the problems, because it's very hard, harder and harder, or almost impossible to look to ahead into the future, but actually to create an organization that is prepared, that knows, that has resources, that has good people, that has a flexible structure, that can be agile, move fast, take decisions. And of course this goes another even deeper level about the mindset. What is the mindset that we have today in growth? What mindset can we adopt to benefit from it? The discipline is a word that sums a lot of the things that we can do. So we can have discipline when we are growing, not to be too obsessed with market share, with entering into pricing wars, whatever, because this actually makes our companies very fragile. When you are no longer making a sound profit and you are just cutting corners, doing a lot of things just to increase market share and getting bonuses, whatever, you know the game, you all know it, you are just fragilizing your company. And of course, when it comes, it hits you. Another thing, a more subtle way of fragilizing your company is when you are squeezing the most out of it, of the company, of the people, of the markets. You are hunting for efficiency, you are 100 or 99% efficient, and the crisis comes and you are too efficient. So you have nothing to cut, no grease to cut, stuff like that. So it's harder to react. So this is an interesting dimension from my point of view, is about how do we prepare economically, strategically, but also mentally for the crisis. Because we know it from the best investors in the world for some time, including Warren Buffett and many others. This is when the big upturns are done. I mean, you are waiting and you might have just a few so big opportunities to grow.
So it's not only about stashing cash aside, because it's not about that. It's about staying agile. It's about learning, continuous, see where you're at. A self-reflective company in a way, and be prepared to see at a moment how to turn.
I would also emphasize a little bit the cultural aspects. The culture, the organizational culture that you have in your company. Because if it's an organizational culture that is very competitive, that is about winning, success, being the first, who is better, who gets more commission, these will be the first people to flee when there is a downturn. And also these people will create a lot of fragility in the company. If you have something that is more inclusive, that we stick to each other, we do things, we have success together, we get benefits together. So we have more of a culture that is more humanistic, more let's help each other, it's not the end of the world. So reinvent ourselves. A few dimensions, you can look at how the decisions make, which people we are hiring, how we are promoting. All this can help a lot.
Thank you very much, Dan, for the time and for the speech and for the opinions.
Thank you.